the weave in first. You can start with the braids if you want and then come back to the weave, but it was easier to do it this way. So I just clipped this hair out of the way, and I have all this that I'm going to do. So I just take my braid, take my glue, and you don't use a lot of glue. You can even use a toothpick or a little cuticle stick if you want. And I don't like to start at the base or the top. I start a little below that. And you just put the glue just like you would if it was a tress, but very sparingly, because when you press it to your head, it's actually going to spread even more. So you want to actually just put it in the center. You don't want to go out to the edges. See, you just want to leave a little space on the edges so that it doesn't spread too much. And you just go down. And you want to find the stopping point. You don't want to go to the end because you're not going to glue it all the way where it starts to extend off of your head. You want to stop the glue, because I made the mistake of putting too much glue going down, and then it got stuck to this hair, and I had to try to peel it off. So make sure you measure where it's going to stop and start coming off your head so that you only put the glue down a little. And you can, if you like, even put the glue on your actual hair in a line and then just take the braid and glue it onto your head. But for me, this worked better. Once again, I just spritz it, and then I come back and put the glue at the very top, and very little glue at the top. If you put too much, it will actually spread out and be at the base. If you see here, I actually put too much glue right there, and you can kind of see the glue. This side, I actually wished I would have done it this way. If you see how I curved these going at an angle and did these straight up, but I had already done it, and I didn't want to go back and try to peel this off my hair because I didn't want to pull my hair off, so I just let it be. So anyhow, I'm going to come, start at the base, get it as close to the other braid as you can without actually gluing it on the braid. You're going to hold it for a little bit and just gently push it up. And it's not going to automatically stick. For some people it may. Like I said, I didn't put enough glue. For me it didn't stick because I don't have any hair, and it's a lot harder to stick to your actual scalp sometimes. So for me, what I had to do was put it on close as possible to the other braid. Just hold it for a little bit. Just hold it. Once I hold it for a little bit and I realize, okay, it's kind of stuck on there, I then take my spritz and just spritz it all the way up. One more time down. And then that kind of makes it stick. Then I get my blow dryer on low, not on high, because I made the mistake of using like medium heat, and this hair, being synthetic, started to get straight at the root. So I actually had to come back and take a few pieces of this out and replace it because the root started getting straight. So make sure you use low heat and just let it go up and down. Dry. I'm going to show you one more, and then I'll finish and come back and show you the bantu knots, because I don't want to run out of time. So I'm just going to come back and then I'm being a little less neat because I know I'm about to take this down, but you want to be very neat in doing this and very precise. Okay, once again, and don't glue it right on the edge. If you see that, I glued it too far in front of my hairline, and it started lifting. You see that, how it started lifting? So try to push it back right behind your hairline, and it'll look more real. Okay, so then you're going to come side by make sure it's not on top of the other. And I chose these colors in the spirit of Jamaica, Rastafarianism, and just because I like these colors, but you can use whatever color you want. You can do all black if you're into a more conservative look, pink if you're into a Hello Kitty kind of look, purple with the summer, whatever color you want. And you can do it whatever design you want. I've also seen even my nieces, they, you know, do designs with hearts and stars and all kinds of stuff. So you can do whatever you want to do to make it unique. So there you go. And just go back. And dry it. I got glue on my face, but it's okay. So anyhow, I'm going to finish these about 1, 2, 3, and then I'll come back and show you. Okay, so I'm back. I finished it, as you can see, if you look closely. That is the finished look. Now, like I said, I could have been a lot more tedious and a lot more neat, which is what you want to do. But since I'll be taking it down in a day or two, I'm just trying to show you the actual technique. And if you were just walking down the street or whatever, doing what you do, nobody would ever know that your hair wasn't braided unless they're like right up on your head, you know, looking like that. And, I mean, nobody really should be in your hair like that. So it creates the illusion that your hair is braided. See? So I think it's cool. I think it's neat and funky and different. And so now I'll show you real quick the bantu knot, which is very easy. Now you can bantu knot it however you want. You can braid it first, but I just took it and actually twisted it like so all the way to almost the end. And when it began to curl up on itself, I just twisted a little more. Twisted, you can see that. And then I just twisted a little more. And then I just started to wrap it underneath itself. Just kept twisting it. Wrapping it. Twisting it with your fingers. Wrapping it. And then when you get to the end, it's not going to come down, so you don't need a hairpin or anything. You can just wrap it under, or you can take a little spritz. Spritz the ends, and then tuck it under. I know a lot of you don't agree with using spritz, but when it comes to the weave, for me, spritz is sometimes my best friend. I know it's not good to use it all the time, but as long as you take care of your hair and condition and do what you're supposed to do, I think it's okay every once in a while. So anyhow, those are the bantu knots, if you can see. And that was just my way. You don't have to do it like that. You can, you know, leave it depending on what hair you use. I'll show you another way. Uh-oh, I think it got stuck. Okay, it was stuck. Depending on what hair you use, you can either leave it out and let it blend in, you know, with the hair, or a lot of people back home do what they call a Chinese knot, where they twist it, but as it's twisting on top of each other, instead of bantuing it, I hope you can see this because I can't tell, instead of bantuing it, they just let it twist on top of each other into like a corkscrew kind of effect, if you can see that. Hope you can see that. I'll show you a picture of some at the end. And you just let it twist on top of each other, like that. And then you leave the ends, you stick a bobby pin or you glue, put glue between each knot and glue it on top of each other, and then you just let your ends stick out like so. Kind of spike it with some hairspray or whatnot. You do it that way also, if you don't want to do it into a complete bantu knot. So you can kind of play with it and do what you want with it, but that's just my method of doing it. So this is my look, and then to make it more centered, I just push it together like so. Just to make it more center so you can actually see the knots. Like I said, I got a lot of compliments. People thought it was different, funky, you know, depending where you are. Probably down south where I'm from, or places where these kind of styles are more affluent, it wouldn't be that big a deal maybe. But I am on the west coast in Nevada, and I haven't seen a lot of people do their hair like this. They may, but I haven't seen it. So something kind of different, but you can kind of add your own way to it, add your own little style to it. So if you decide to create your own version of this style, either the Frohawk or the quickweave braids, just let me know and send me a video response so I can see your technique and how you do it. And don't forget to accessorize. You can put a braid earring in if you want to do something funky. These are my handmade braid earrings. If you want to do something like that, you can do something like that. Or if that's a little too risque for you, you can just rock a big hoop. I just added a few cowrie shells.